Hey folks, this is Helge Alexy from the Cardiology Forum, and today I welcome you to another episode of our STEMI Pearls series, this time part 3. And today we want to try to presume, while we have an ECG pattern of an inferior myocardial infarction STEMI, where the culprit lesion might be. So enjoy. And if we have such an ECG with very easy to notice ST elevation in 2, 3 and AVF, so an inferior myocardial infarction, but with also ST elevation in V5 and V6 as posterior lateral myocardial infarction as well, and ST depressions on the contrary in 1 and AVL as well as in V1 till V3. And if you have this pattern, there are two different possibilities where the culprit lesion might be. It might be the RCA or the LCX. And in some patients that are unstable, the hemodynamics are going down, you don't want to waste time intubating the wrong vessel because you think, for example, this is a classical pattern for an RCA occlusion. Then you try to intubate the RCA. It's very difficult. You spend 3 or 4 minutes intubating it, and after visualizing the vessel, you see, oh, it's not the right vessel. There's not the occlusion, but the culprit is in the LCX. And till you revascularize the LCX, the patient has already deteriorated in the hemodynamics and you are in a lot of trouble. So it would be nice to try to define the culprit vessel just from looking at the ECG and then deciding the culprit lesion will be in the LCX or the RCA and going directly with an EBU or an Judkins right directly into the right vessel, right? So the first possibility is that the culprit lesion would be in the LCX if you have this myocardial infarction. If you have a very huge LCX with giving an LPDA or the PDA is coming from the left system, then the myocardial the inferior myocardium of the left ventricle will be supplied by blood and oxygen by this LPDA from the LCX and is encoding for the ST elevation in 2, 3 and AVF. And because of all these obtuse marginal branches here, the posterior lateral part is also supplied by the LCX, and you would have these ST elevation in V5 and V6. That is one of two possibilities. The second would be that you have a very huge RCA that is also causing the ST elevation in 2, 3 AVF. It is occluded with its PDA here. But if we have a very big RPLD of the RCA, it also supplies the posterior lateral part of the left ventricle myocardium, and you have also these ST elevation in V5 and V6. So both vessels can encode for exactly the same ECG patterns. So it would be nice to presume what vessel is causing this, and there is a way I want to show you where you can try. It's not always right, but it is a bigger chance that you choose the right culprit vessel in these cases. If you have a look at the inferior limb leads, and especially at lead 2 and V3. And what we want to do is measuring the size of the ST elevation in 2 and lead 3. And in this example, for example, you have a ST elevation of 7 millimeters or 7 millivolts, whatever, and 8 millimeters in the lead 3. So you then compare these two values and have a ratio. If you have a bigger value, a bigger ST elevation in lead 3 than in lead 2, it most probably will be a RCA problem. As I said, it's not a rule, but it's a little guide to presume the right coronary that we presume to be the culprit vessel. And in this case, we had an intermediate to high grade stenosis in the mid RCA, and then an abrupt occlusion of the medial to distal part of the RCA that is causing this ECG. And after revascularization of the RCA, you see this huge vessel where the PDA going here and an RPLD here that is encoding exactly for this ECG pattern with a ST elevated in 2-3 AVF through the PDA, and the posterolateral part of the RCA is encoding for the ST elevation in lead V5 and V6. So this would be the first possibility, and let's have a look at this ECG pattern. Almost the same structure. We have ST elevation in lead 2-3 AVF as well as V5 and V6. And then we also have a look at the inferior limb leads, and especially in lead 2 and V3 and lead 2 and lead 3. And then we measure the ST elevations again. And this time we have a value of 4 millimeters in lead 2 and a value of 3 millimeters in lead 3. So this time the ST elevation is greater in lead 2 than in lead 3. And let's move me aside a little bit. And this would encode for the LCX. Most probably the culprit lesion is lying in the LCX in this time. So if you have the coronary angiogram afterwards, in this case you would have a proximal occlusion of the LCX. You see some distal parts here retrogradely with a retrograde flow, and if you revascularize this LCX, you see what a huge vessel this is, where the left PDA supplying the inferior part of the myocardial infarction of the left ventricle, and the posterolateral part over these obtuse marginals here. So these are the two possibilities. And let's conclude this session with the following. You always want to have a look at lead 2 and V3 in an inferior myocardial infarction to presume where the culprit lesion would be. And if the ST elevation is greater in lead 2 than in lead 3, you most probably have the culprit lesion in the LCX. And if the ST elevation is bigger in lead 3 than in lead 2, you most probably have the culprit lesion in the RCA. So that's it for now. That was the today's part of the STEMI Pearls series. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did so, please subscribe to our channel. Yours, Helge Alexy. Bye bye.